At times, you might find that an image is simply too dark. That might be because the original was underexposed or because a reproduction was created a little bit too dark. But in any event, when you have an image that is just overall too dark, you may want to apply a quick adjustment in order to bring out some more of the shadow detail in the image. I'm going to show you a very quick and easy method for instantly brightening up the image overall. This effect will brighten all values except black or white. Obviously, white can't be brightened any more than it already is, and the particular technique I'm going to show you will not affect black in the image, but any tonal values in between will be affected. Let's take a look at this very simple process. I'll start off by creating a copy of the background image layer. So on the Layers panel, I'll drag the thumbnail for the background image layer down to the Create New Layer button, the blank sheet of paper icon at the bottom of the Layers panel. When I release the mouse, a background copy will be created. I can then change the blend mode for this layer. The default blend mode is normal. You can see that option selected with the pop-up at the top left of the Layers panel, but I can click on that pop-up to change to a different blend mode. In this case, I want to use the screen blend mode. That will blend the values for my background copy with the background image layer itself, brightening up all pixel values, again, except for pixels that were already either black or white. I'll turn off the visibility for this layer, and you can see it's almost like a fill flash effect has been added to the image. We have an instant brightening of all of the detail within the photo. If you decide the effect was a little bit too strong, you can reduce the opacity using the control at the top right of the Layers panel. Simply reduce the value for opacity in order to dial back the effect. In this case, I think I'll tone it down just a little bit so we don't have quite as strong a brightening of the midtones within the photo. I can then compare the before and after by turning off the visibility for the background copy layer. There's the before, and then I'll turn on the background copy layer again, and that gives us the after. So with a very simple process, creating a background copy, changing the blend mode to screen, and then perhaps reducing the opacity of that background copy layer, we're able to pull out quite a bit of shadow detail in the image with very little effort.